Oh. O God, strengthen those who hope in you. Graciously hear our pleas. And since without you, mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands, we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them and everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, one member, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in the one Spirit we are all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free. And we are all made to drink of one Spirit, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Of their initiation into the life of Christ. Christ, and to seal them with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Father, very much. Thank you, young people, for standing up. I know Father asked you to stand, and you replied to him by standing up. But I'm very pleased that you did that, because when I come into parishes, I'll stand here for a moment on a step. Sometimes I wish I was tall. There's a lot of you there. To complete the initiation into the life of Christ. Thank you, Father. That's a very nice phrase. To complete your initiation into the life of Christ. When I come into parishes, I always ask the confirmation class, or confirmandi, that's who you are, in Latin, those to be confirmed, confirmandi, to stand. And I do that for two reasons. First of all, in some parishes, and this is a big class, so maybe it's not always possible here with large classes, but their names are read out, and then your names are read out, each one stands as your name is read out. And the young person, be it young man or young woman, will say, here I am, here I am. Now, when I was in school, I guess they still do this, that's what I figure out when I talk to young people. I remember when I was in school, you go into classroom, you sit down, and the teacher has a roll call, you know, and your name is read out, and there you are sitting in your desk or something, and you'll say something like present, right? Something like that, right? Present. And that's interesting because that means that your body is present, you're physically present, but your mind could be almost anywhere, right? Your mind could be at the playground, could be thinking at home, something you like to do, rather than sitting in the classroom. You say present, it means you are physically present. But what I like about the word here I am is this. You kind of introduce yourself. Here I am. My whole self. Not just my body, but my body and soul, my whole self. Here I am. You kind of present yourself. And that's beautiful. Because at your age, all of you, you had to make a decision to be confirmed. You know, your parents support you, they love you, your sponsors are with you, here they are right there in the parish community. But at your age, you have to make this decision yourself to be confirmed. You've been saying, here I am, for quite some time. You didn't use the words, but you've been in a period of preparation for confirmation. Nobody forced you. You had to do this on your own two feet. It's something you wanted to do. So you present yourself on this confirmation day. Here I am. It's all about faith. It's all about faith. We come to church on Sunday, which is the Lord's day. It's given to the Lord, right? As a community of people, we say, here I am. Maybe it was a good week. Maybe it was a hard week. Maybe it was a fantastic week. Whatever it was, we come to the Lord's day, Lord, here I am. It's all about faith. It's all about faith. So, if I was to come to you, Tatiana, and I say, Tatiana, what would you say? Here I am, thanks, Tatiana. How about you, Christian? Christian, I am here, here I am, right? Here I am, here I am. Introducing yourself, thank you, Christian. How about you, Christine, Christiana? Here, thank you, Christiana. Okay, Sienna. Here I am, what a beautiful name. Now, this is Portuguese, but is it Yao? Huh? João. João. Here I am. Thank you very much. Thank you. You brought yourself to confirmation. You brought yourself. How long have you been studying for confirmation? Huh? Since I love this answer. Because you're referring to something more than this year. You said 7 years since kindergarten. You've been preparing your Christian faith for a long time, Sydney. What a great answer that was. What a great answer. How about you, Philippe? 2 years of confirmation. You've been saying, here I am the whole time. This is your decision. Very important. Your decision. That's the first reason I asked you to stand up, to remind all of us that it's all about faith. We present ourselves. Right? We present ourselves.
God can't open our hearts. Only you can do that. That's the one thing God can't do. He can't force you because we have free will. Very important. Second reason. I know that it's not easy to stand up in public. I know that. As a group, even though I look around this church, I see these people, their smiling faces, they're very supportive of you. It's not easy to stand up in front of people you know sometimes, let alone by yourself. To stand up by yourself in front of other people is not easy. Confirmation has to do with that. Confirmation has to do with standing up for Jesus today. Not to be afraid, not to be ashamed that I am Catholic, that I am Christian. Not to be afraid or ashamed to make the sign of the cross in public. Not to be afraid or ashamed to say grace, even in a restaurant, in front of other people. Not to be ashamed or afraid when your peer group comes to you. And I know this from my own experience growing up, because one of my friends didn't go to church. They asked me questions. Do you go to church? Do you believe in Jesus? Do you go to confession? Do you go to communion? And I was a little bit afraid, because they're my peer group. But I gathered my thoughts together and I said, yes. I said, yes. Standing up for Jesus, by you standing up today, it reminds all of us whether we're 13, 14, 45, 85, it's all the same for us. Especially today, it's very important. So thank you for standing up and reminding all of us of some very important things. Have a seat. I know that your teacher probably said to you, you know, that the bishop's going to ask you some questions, right? And we may be a little nervous. I don't know if you're nervous or not, but that's good. You don't do it, but I'm glad you're back. But I thought maybe this great big stick or something would kind of scare you, right? Well, let's start it this way. Like, why do you want to confirm? Like, what does confirmation mean to you? What does confirmation mean? What happens in confirmation? Like, what does it mean to you? What's going on today? Why is it important? Don't be shy. Don't be shy. What's that about? If you're a crystal Pentecost, see, that's a great answer. I wonder how many of us in this room to know would know the meaning of that. It's a crystal Pentecost, right? You're absolutely right. By the way, good name, Ricardo. It's a good name, right? Yes. Tell me about that. How is it a crystal Pentecost, Ricardo? You're referring to sacraments. Okay, thank you. Anybody else? What happens in confirmation? Not what, but who do you receive in confirmation? Who do you receive in confirmation? Yeah. The Holy Spirit. Thank you. Girls, the boys have got two answers so far. You've answered zero. Don't be shy. Don't be shy. Absolutely. Absolutely. We receive the Holy Spirit. Right? And this young man, Ricardo, said the first Pentecost was 50 days after the resurrection, when the Holy Spirit came down upon the church, right? And we were ready because of that. I'll explain why in a moment, right? Very good. Now, confirmation comes from two Latin words, con and firmare. Formation, firmare. Con means with, firmare means strengthened. To be strengthened in the Holy Spirit. That's what confirmation is. To be strengthened in the Holy Spirit. Okay. Very important. To be strengthened. That's got to be good. That's got to be very good. When was the first time you received the Holy Spirit? Yes, the other girls are catching up. Yes. Thank you very much, Isabella. In baptism, we receive the Holy Spirit. Right? Baptism. Absolutely. Now, tell me something. Why do we have our babies baptized? Why do we have baptism, Isabella? Pardon me? Yes, well, one with the Holy Spirit, one with the church. As a matter of fact, that's a good answer. Hang on to that for a second. What's important about baptism? What else? What else can we say about baptism? What happens to baptism? Anybody? Yes, Christiana. Okay, so it's certainly the initial step in the Christian life, baptism, absolutely, yes. You first receive the Holy Spirit, that's right. You're all on the same track here. Did you get up this morning and wash your face? Yeah, with water, right? Exactly. Water is a cleansing, right? We use water to clean ourselves, right? Well, you know, there's a kind of a spiritual cleansing that happens in baptism. Eh? There's a spiritual cleansing, yes, oh yeah. Thank you very much. You are cleansed of original sin, right? This original sin is a great mystery. It's a sin that comes from Adam and Eve that affects all mankind, and you're washed clean of original sin and baptism, right? That's one thing. And the second one is that we become members of the body of Christ. Do you have a family of faith? You do. You're a family. Do you have a family of faith? I've got a family. How about you, Logan? He's got a family. This is pretty good. You got a family, you guys. Now, how did you all get into the family? How did you all get into the family? Did you write a letter of application? No, that's kind of crazy. You're like, what? Yeah, you're born into the family. That's fantastic. Okay, let me tell you something. You are born into a family, right? Okay. I was born a long time ago. Very long time ago. A very, very long time ago. I was born, I won't tell you the year, but I was born at St. Michael's Hospital in Lethbridge, Alberta. Okay? I was born a son of my parents, and my siblings were born later on when the family moved west to Vancouver. Right? They were all born in Vancouver. I was born in St. Michael's Hospital in Lethbridge, Alberta. Let me tell you something. I was born twice. I was born twice. I was born twice. 1 month later, I was born to Jesus in the Holy Spirit in St. Patrick's Church in Lethbridge, Alberta, in the waters of baptism. I was born twice. I was born in the human way to my family, who I love very much, but I was filled with the Holy Spirit in baptism. I became a Christian in the waters of baptism. The faith of my parents brought me there, and I was washed clean in the Holy Spirit, and I became a member of the family of Christ. What do you call a family of Christ? It starts with the letter C. Church. This is a church building, right? Beautiful. We Catholics respect our church buildings very much, very much. But if this building wasn't here, would we still have the church? We would. Because you're the church, and I'm the church, because we are temples of the Holy Spirit as of our baptism. You are my sister, I am your brother. You are my sister, I am your brother. You are my brother, I am your brother. We share the same spiritual DNA. We have received the Holy Spirit. That's why Jesus says, our Father. When a young baby is born, like it's all wet, right? Kind of all wet. The water breaks, the mother's womb, and there you go, the baby's born. It's all wrinkled, it's kind of ugly, you know, right? But real fast they get cute. Real fast they get cute. Isn't that interesting? That what happens in the human way when we're born from our mother, spiritually in the waters of baptism, are a womb in which we are born spiritually to Jesus. Saint Louis, King of France, great king and a holy man. He used to write his name this way. This is true. Saint Louis of France. He would say, Louis of Poissy. Louis of, one day, somebody came to your majesty. Why do you write Louis of Poissy? You have nothing to do with that village of Poissy at all. You're born in Paris. And Louis says, oh, no. I was born to Jesus in the village of Poissy, in the waters of baptism. There I received the Holy Spirit. Then the gates of heaven were opened to me. There I became a Christian. You are born twice. What would it be for us Catholics to remember this more often in our life, that there is something very, very special about baptism? We are born twice. We are people born twice. We are born into Jesus because of our baptism. Where were you born the first time, Sydney? Where were you born? Here in Winnipeg. Okay. Great start. Now, where were you born in Jesus? In this church. You were filled with the Holy Spirit in this church. Where's the baptismal font, Father Nico? Right there. Right there, the water of baptism. Right there. When I go to St. Patrick's Church, I look at the baptismal font there on Lethbridge in St. Patrick's, and I think that's where I receive Jesus. Faith brings you to baptism, and baptism fills you with the Holy Spirit, and confirmation strengthens you in the Holy Spirit. Because your parents at home, they want you to grow and be a success and use your talents and all that kind of thing, and all of that's good. Spiritually speaking, we've got to mature as well. And that's why Jesus has sent us the Holy Spirit as a gift to help us to grow in maturity. Absolutely. We are given the Holy Spirit to help us grow in maturity. Baptism and confirmation are completely connected together. Your baptism is not complete unless you are confirmed. You're born, but you've got to grow. How many times have you been baptized? Once. How many times have you been confirmed? Once. How many times have you received Holy Communion? Like many times, right? Isn't that interesting? Baptized once, confirmed once, Holy Communion many times. Baptism and confirmation tells you your identity in Jesus Christ as filled with the Holy Spirit. And Holy Eucharist we receive often because that's how we participate in the life of Jesus in our daily lives. We call them the sacraments of initiation. All three are connected together. Today you are receiving the gift of the Spirit today. How special is that? How special is that? How many gifts are there in the Holy Spirit? Yeah. There are actually seven gifts of the Holy Spirit. We identify seven gifts because the Bible says so. Even back as far as Isaiah in the Old Testament. Give me a gift. Wisdom's a gift. Give me a gift. Time's a gift. Give me a gift. God's gift. Give me a gift. Fear of the Lord. Fear of the Lord's gift. Give me a gift. Fortitude. Fortitude's a gift. Give me a gift. Huh? Hiding. Right? Seven. Am I missing one? Did we get like the letter U? I understand. Did I get them all? Did I get them all? Yes. Knowledge is a gift. Give me a gift. I think that's it. Seven gifts of the Holy Spirit. In the Bible, it says that Jesus was filled with these gifts of the Holy Spirit. They're real. When I was coming into the church today, it wasn't good. I was blessing the people here, right? But you know what I was thinking? I was saying to the Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, help me speak to the other people today. Holy Spirit, give me courage. Holy Spirit, give me knowledge. Give me understanding. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit. The most important thing I can say to you today is never forget to pray to the Holy Spirit. Never forget to pray to the Holy Spirit. When I meet young people I confirmed 2 years ago, 3 years ago, 4 years ago, whatever, I always say to them when I meet them, they say, Bishop, you confirmed me 3 years ago. You know what I say to them? I say, are you still praying to the Holy Spirit? And sometimes they look down on the ground and say, yes. I met a young man the other day. I said to him, are you still praying for the Holy Spirit? He says, you betcha. Never forget to pray for the Holy Spirit. See, Bishop Richard Lewis, I can't open your heart. How do you know the plan? With what? Big wood or small wood? Big wood. Big wood? Right off the bat? Small wood, okay? Let's see. Small wood. Dry wood or wet wood? Dry wood, okay, so you get a bit of small, tiny piece of dry wood, right? And you get a match or something, right? You light it, right? You got a tiny little spark. How do you get that thing a bit bigger? You can't put big wood on yet because it's too small a spark, right? Too small a flame. How do you get bigger? What do you have to do? Smaller wood, you're gonna blow. You blow on it, get some oxygen, don't worry. breath of God. You blow on the flame to get bigger, to get bigger. And it grows and it grows and grows because you're adding breath and adding oxygen to that fire. You know what we call that spiritually? We call that prayer. Because when the Holy Spirit first came down upon the apostles 2,000 years ago, we know in the Bible, there were tons of fire on their foreheads. That's why you're wearing red. That's why I'm wearing red. Because of the first Pentecost, little tons of fire. But guess what? It's up to you to make that flame grow because you have complete freedom of heart to pray to the Holy Spirit or not. Christ leaves that job up to you. Come, Holy Spirit, fill my heart with courage. Come, Holy Spirit, strengthen me. It doesn't matter what age you are. That's what I meant to the good folks here. When I said to the folks in the church today that confirmation affects all of us because we have received the Holy Spirit. How is the relationship with the Holy Spirit in our life, right? The most important thing I can say to you is never forget to pray to the Holy Spirit. Do you like sports? Like what sports do you like? Volleyball? Okay. Let me catch your first name. Huh? The foul? You like volleyball. Guess what? I figured you can use it again, right? You like that idea? So I go to the store and I see the best volleyball I can possibly buy. I take out my credit card. I buy this fantastic volleyball. Like, I don't know where it was made, but it's the best volleyball in the world. So I give it to you. The foul, here's a beautiful gift for you, the foul. She looks at it and goes, well, you know, it's not that. I'm not here for volleyball at home. I'm not on the shelf. I may use it, I may not use it, whatever. Tell me something. Is that really a gift? Not really, because a gift takes two people. The giver, I'm trying to make it a gift. But for a gift to be a gift, it's got to be wanted, it's got to be received, it's got to be desired, right? Think about the Lord, what he's done for us. Suffering on the cross and sending us the Holy Spirit. And how often whenever we think of the Holy Spirit in our lives. When we are filled with the Holy Spirit, we are filled with God. And this starts with our baptism. Value the gift, desire the gift, want the gift, and invite the gift into your life. Why? Why? Well, that's the final thing I'm going to say. We come to God. You know that. We're used to that. We hear God's word from the pulpit over there. The word of God is sent to us. It goes in our ears. But I wonder if it goes into our hearts. You see, it's a long journey from here to here. It's a long, long journey. And the word of God. Then we celebrate the Mass of Eucharist. And after Eucharist, after you receive Holy Communion, what happens? Like, basically, when there's one prayer, maybe a hymn, but one prayer. And then what? Out the doors of the church. We are confirmed for going out there in the world and witnessing and standing up for Jesus Christ. We've got a job to do. We are confirmed with the gifts of the Holy Spirit to help us grow and mature ourselves, but to witness to Jesus Christ in the world. We do that by standing up for Jesus and by having a heart of love for our neighbor, by doing good for our neighbor and changing the world and making the world a better place. The apostles couldn't read or write. They were simple fishermen. Simple fishermen. They were afraid to stand up and talk. And something happened. Something happened. We heard about that in the reading today. Something happened. They stood up in front of thousands of people and witnessed to Jesus. Why? Not because of their talents, not because they were good fishermen or bad fishermen, because of the Holy Spirit they had received. Never forget the Holy Spirit. At Mass, listen to what the priest says at the end of Mass. Go now, beloved, and serve the Lord. Or something like, go now. We come to go. We come to. Mass means the sending forth. Missio, missionary. That's what the Mass is. We come to go, to witness, to change the world. Because if we don't stand up for Jesus, who will? Many people have an idea of God, some kind of God, some idea of God. But it's only the Christian who can witness to Jesus Christ. The Bible says, no one can call Jesus Lord except by the Holy Spirit. Why do we believe Jesus is our Savior? Why? Where did that come from? Did we invent that? Where does that come from? It comes from the Holy Spirit. You see? When God's out, confirmation is powerful, important, and serious. When you're young people, are you ready to receive the gift of the Holy Spirit today? Are you ready to be perfect? You've been preparing for something.
Guide me, protect me.
I know you love me, Jesus, and I want to love you more and more. And as you're using words like that in your heart, I will say my prayer. My dear friends, in baptism, God our Father gave the new birth of eternal life to his chosen sons of God. Let us pray to our Father that he will pour out the Holy Spirit to strengthen his sons and daughters with his gifts and anoint them to be more like Christ, the Son of God. And just for a moment of silence, I want to invite everybody in the church today, everybody in the Immaculate Conception Church today, to pray for these young people. Pray for them in the Holy Spirit, that the Holy Spirit will be strong in them, guide them in the days ahead, the years ahead, protect them. Let's just pause for a moment of prayer. All-powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, you freed your sons and daughters from sin and gave them new life. Send your Holy Spirit upon them to be their helper and guide. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of right judgment and courage, the spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with the spirit of wonder and awe in your presence, through Christ our Lord. Amen. I will now invite the confirmandi to come forward with your sponsors as you have prepared. Dylan, sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit,
the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Siamo sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Abba, sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you.
Peace be with you. Be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit.
confirmed, who have received the fullness of God's Spirit, that standing at the altar of the Lord, they may share the banquet of Christ's sufferings. Come and God, their Father, and in the midst of the church, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For their parents and godparents who love them in faith, that by word and example they may always encourage them to follow the way of Jesus Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the Holy Church of God, in union with the Pope Francis, Richard our Bishop, and all the bishops, thank God who gathers us together by the Holy Spirit, to help us grow in unity of faith and love until His Son returns in glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord.
For all men and women of every race and nation, that they may acknowledge the one God as Father, and in the bond of common fellowship, seek His kingdom, which is peace and joy in the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, Heavenly Father, you are the source of all that is good. We come to you today with these prayers we have made as a community of faith. We make them to you through Jesus, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
sinners, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who in the offerings presented here, provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you love in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the
giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of the church, together with Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and with him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that ye should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
I invite you to bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Confirm, O God, what you have brought about in us, and preserve in the hearts of your faithful the gifts of the Holy Spirit. May they never be ashamed to confess Christ crucified before the world, and by the Lord of charity, may they ever fulfill his commands, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.